Hey guys, and welcome to another episode of Tales of Zestiria. Let's get started, shall we? And I feel like we're near the end. And I thought I had found a dragon. So much for my hopes being in vain. Can't do that, Mom. Quick, save it. We were gonna fight this humongous monster. I thought it was a dragon. Oh, look, I found some strawberry shortcake and pound cake. Millipede. 32. Why isn't it targeting me? Not really. It's pretty stupid that it would just target the air. But hey, at least we leveled up. That's always good.
It's over.
I leveled up to level 30. All right, it's been an amazing adventure. Let's call it quits. fuck no. An ominous malevolent swirls around here. Only Lila may enter. Do you wish to enter? Yes.
Thank you.
Therian.
To level 24.
I had to use an elixir. Oh, crap. Okay. I can just survive against these two. Come on, we just got to level two. Yeah. Dang, that was hard. That was hard. Let's go back in front of the crucible. I have a feeling if we go back in, we can clear out more. But I am, of course, gonna quick save it. I didn't expect it to be so easy. Well, that was easy. I guess we already did it. Samgata. Guess then we go this way. Go out to garden. We found some red sage. Either cave, the cave is large and spacious, some caution to prevent accidents. Golden Chief, Village Chief. Grim gear. We're gonna quick save it. We're just gonna take a little look around the cave. I might come back later. Right now, garden is important. Garden should be close. Maybe they can hear us from here. Hey, Garden, we're right here.
was that?
Mm-hmm.
What kind of bird is this?
A griff kite. It's a bird in my kite family.
There's another one over there, too. Very high up.
Yeah, they're excellent at reading the wind.
Look at it soar. Swift and free.
Yeah. Through a sky clouded in malevolence wrought by Earth dwellers.
You don't suppose the griffin started out once as a griff kite?
Perhaps.
Malevolence deforms everything. Nature alike. But malevolence can be cleansed.
Through serenity.
Through all of us. That's all.
Wow.
That's probably kind of loud. I do apologize. But I am thirsty and hungry. You know the feeling. Well, we're gonna have to fight our way past here. What, there's a Norman? Oh! How many Norman does that make now? Seventeen. Wow. I got an idea. Let's go to Garden. Commands. Oh, right. Some of you say commands. Some of you say, I forgot about those. Do you regularly forget to breathe as well? When surrounded by enemies, just give the order to spread out when you want to hammer an enemy's weakness. Just tell everyone to focus attacks with effective commands. You can control the flow of battle as though you're conducting an orchestra. Yeah, if you know every little detail, I bet that's true.
Hello.
Hello there.
Is this new-looking building your school? That's right. The village chief built it. For the future of the village.
A school? It's a bit plain compared to the rest of the town, don't you think? Are you kidding? We didn't have anything like this in my village.
I think it's thanks to the Pope.
You say that like you own the place.
Seems like a nice village. Sort of reminds me of Alicia.
Sorry.
I know. We'll split up and try and find some clues about the Pope.
And they couldn't hear you that far away? We have crop failures and bizarre incidents going on for heck knows how long, but everything's fine now. Young ones who went to the capital in order to make money are back, and the people whose health was deteriorating are well again. It's all thanks to the chief. Now listen, the residents of this town are like one big family, and our family bonds will see us through the age of chaos. The village chief is the one that taught us this.
What's wrong? You look troubled. It's strange. This village seems rather prosperous. And that's a problem? The issue is why? Their source of income? Right. The land in this area is infertile and hardly fit for farming or hunting. It's far from any major thoroughfare, and they have no local products to export.
Isn't that weird? You'd think a place like this would be the first to fall victim to famine.
There must be some explanation for all this.
There's gotta be some reason that a village like this is prosperous as it is. Let's look into it, but be careful don't arouse the suspicion of the villagers. They seem edgy around us. My dad says that you can't trust people from the capital. He says they look down on us, but the chief said it's bad to think bad things about other people. Since Lynch took over as the chief of the village, it's been totally transformed. He made sure that we have enough food supplies and the funding for the school. It's thanks to him we are living happily today. Okay, we found the inn. There used to be another entrance to the Pure Land, but it collapsed during the earthquake. Where was it, you said? In the place with all the rocks, in the southwest of the village. We haven't studied the alphabet yet at school. I like math, though. It's super fun. Cool. We had crop failures and bizarre incidents going on for heck knows how long. I think I talked to you, Mr. Heck Knows Long.
Gadadin sure seems like a happy village.
Indeed, everyone here is so positive and active. They're all like family here.
But I still can't feel the blessing of the Seraphim.
True. The guardian Seraph is missing. It seems that this place used to be rather barren, but it looks like the current chief was able to overcome these issues.
I can tell the people here respect him a whole lot.
I imagine they do. This would normally be such a desolate environment.
Yeah, not just anyone could pull that one off.
Rose, is something the matter?
Sorry, I was just thinking out loud. I'll tell you more once I've had time to investigate.
If you're thinking what I'm thinking, the chief is the Pope. That's what I think. I imagine a village such as this would be a comfortable home for a lord of the land. Sadly, though, it appears that none here to give their blessing. Or maybe he's a Seraphim.
What's wrong, Edna?
Nothing. Just thinking about how Meepo insulted me earlier.
Oh, I see.
Anyway, it looks like there's some kind of ruin in the back of the village, and it's a pretty darn old one to boot.
How old do you think?
It's probably from before the Dark Period. It might be even older than I am.
You don't mean from the Temperance of Averrost? If that's true, then this is an incredible find! Wait, hey, Edna? How old are...
What?
Never mind.
School of God. I'll show you, Meepo. You rule the day. All the ends are the same. Choose one room, choose another, it gets quite boring. Don't you think? God and as well to be charitable, it's rustic. To be less durable, it's poor. There isn't much use for a weaponsmith here, so I'm more like the village's blacksmith. Four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. 30, 40, 50. Father was a genius, like everybody says. An ordinary man with extraordinary technique, that's all. An ordinary man, tormented by the knowledge that the tools he made were used to kill his fellow man.
Dezel, have you found any clues about the Pope yet?
No.
Well, if you do come across anything, let me know.
One thing bothers me. The chief. There was something out of place in his personal effects.
His glasses. Lenses are a precious rarity. They're usually only available to those of nobility or holy orders.
And Slam showed up here recently. There's dots there if you want to connect them.
You mean to say the chief is...
I'm just saying the possibility is there. Don't quote me on it.
I'll look further into it. Thank you.
Don't. Huh? All I'm saying is there's no need to thank me.
All right.
What happens if I want to thank you? Jerose has dug up some info on her end as well. Don't be wasting time.
There's a ruin!
Wait!
You think they came here to apprehend the chief?
They better not. Without our chief, Gadadin is doomed.
There's no cause for worry yet. As long as they stay out of the Pure Land, we'll be alright.
Malevolence!
Let's go.
There was malevolence coming from the chief. Why?
I bet we'll find the answer inside that ruin.
Yeah.
The cave at the end of town? Yeah, we call it the Pure Lands. The only village... Only the village chief is allowed inside. Town rules, I'm afraid. Until I find my journey ends. even if it takes tens of thousand years. Oh yeah, I made a new map. You know the cave that we see at the bottom of the cliff at the right hand side when you come out of the village? In there, the cave is its name. Well, there used to be bends living in there. They managed to get rid of them when I was young, but it's awfully deep. But there's still with their loot. Will still be stashed away somewhere. If I were only a bit younger and more adventurous. This journey of mine won't end until I found Sin. I'll keep going even if it takes me a thousand years. Roll cake, roll cow. Can't let outsiders into the Pure Lands. Sorry, but the rules are the rules. Don't mistake my rules, for it is a rule.
Building a school to preserve the village's future. I have to respect that.
A school, huh? Always wished I could have gone to one.
Yeah, me too.
You too, Rose?
I grew up on the road. The older folks at the Scattered Bones were like my teachers. You may not look it, but Roche is actually super good at calligraphy, and he knows a ton about literature.
Huh. Egil looks like he's no slouch either.
Yeah, he was the one who drilled me in martial arts and stealth skills. You might say he's my gym teacher.
Well, that's one way to get kids their exercise.
Same with me and Miglio. Pretty much everyone in Elysia wound up serving as our teachers.
Reminds me of Gramps' etiquette class. He was really strict.
And that's how Miglio got the way he is today.
Whereas you didn't learn a thing, huh?
Hey, that's not true.
Yeah, right. You were always reading the Celestial Record.
You did the same thing.
Yes, but I read it to enhance my history and classical language studies.
And you're saying I didn't?
So, pretty much the same things you do now.
Fair enough. So yeah, we weren't lonely per se, but...
It would have been nice to study and play with other kids our age.
Yeah, I feel you.
Alright, well that's gonna end this episode there. If you liked it, leave a like. If you want a comment, leave a comment. And I'll see you in the next video. See ya.